I want it to look like I'm running.
Go ahead and run. We'll use a faster shutter speed.
Wait, so I don't have to hold this pose? What's up, everyone? I'm Trisha Hirschberger, and in this episode of DIY in 5, we're going to teach you about the last of the three pillars of photography, shutter speed. If you want to learn about the other two pillars, check out our previous videos on ISO and aperture by clicking this annotation / card / link in the description. So what is a camera shutter? The easiest way to think of a camera shutter is to think of a door at the end of a hallway. When you look down the hallway, just on the other side of the door sits the camera sensor. When the door or shutter opens, the light hits the sensor and creates the picture. Once the picture is created, the door immediately closes. So when we hear people say shutter speed, that's simply the speed at which the door opens and closes. Some people also call this exposure time. It's the total time that the camera's sensor is exposed to light. Generally, shutter speed is measured in fractions of a second. Your camera will have settings of 1/4, 1/250th, 1/500th, and so on. But you can also take pictures with your shutter speed open for multiple seconds or minutes even. When a shutter speed is fast, it can freeze action in the picture so you can see the seams of a ball being thrown, or the feathers of a bird as it flies by. Now, if you slow down your shutter speed, you can create a sense of motion in the image. For instance, a car driving by that has a slight blur to make it feel like it's moving. Now that you know what shutter speed is and how it can affect your images, how do you know which one to select? This is where trial and error comes in. Generally speaking, for anything moving where you want to freeze the action, you'll want to use a setting of 1/500th or higher. If your subject is really fast, like a bird flapping its wings, you might have to go to 1/1000th or higher. If you want to take pictures of landscapes at night or add some motion to your picture, what about that? That's when a longer exposure will help. For nighttime landscapes, you might set your shutter to 15 seconds or more to get all the necessary light to make a well-exposed image. If you're just going for a little bit of motion blur on a moving object, you might choose 1/10th or 1/25th of a second. If you want to see some cool long shutter photos, I shudder to think you wouldn't subscribe. We're going to give you tips on long exposure photography in our next video. I'm so funny today. Let us know what other photography questions you have in the comments below so that we can answer them in future DIY in 5 videos. I'm Trisha Hirschberger, and thank you for watching.